Note on reservation road. This film has at least two actors that I like very much. Joaquin Phoenix, he's the hero. And he is wonderful, from Gladiator to Her, wonderful actor. And he is Ethan Lerner. His partner is Jennifer Connelly, beautiful and extremely gifted, talented actress. Third player is Mark Ruffalo, and he's Dwight Arnold. Mark Ruffalo had some good work, but I am biased now, I must confess, ever since I learned a few weeks ago that he signed a petition with Oliver Stone and others to support a letter of support for Mélenchon in the French presidential elections. Man far at the left, man who wants to join the Bolivarian revolution. So, with that, I became very disappointed. I lived under communism. This sort of thing makes me puke. Anyway, so it's maybe for the better that he has the role of the negative, the monster in the film. So, at the beginning we see the couple, Grace and Ethan, with their two children, preparing to drive home. Same thing happens to Dwight Arnold, he's taking his son with his car. And in the Lerner family car, the boy has Josh has a jar in which he has some bugs, and I forgot the bugs with the light, phosphorescent. Anyway, so as they talk in the car, the mother says, "Look, if you keep them in there, they will die." So, anyway, they stop at the gas station, and the boy is moving from the gas station towards the road to free the bugs. And his mother, Grace, would reproach herself a few times after that for having said this. I'm responsible, I killed him. If I wouldn't say that, anyway, he would stay at the car and not go to free the box. And as he's near the road, Dwight Arnold is approaching the car. He's not attentive, phone rings, something, and he makes a wrong move and runs over the boy and kills him, Josh. He doesn't stop and continues driving. Father is terrified, of course. Ethan sees the car as it approaches, hits the boy and moves on. The police ambulance come at the scene of the crime, and the policeman, the detective, is asking, "Did you see?" Just very briefly, it looked like he had something. Couldn't see his face, maybe a hat or a cap. It was an SUV or a pickup truck. The model, I don't know. Color, dark, maybe blue. So he doesn't know. They are devastated. He wants to stay on, but the officer, the sheriff, whatever it is, law enforcement official, says you better go with your family, you have a wife and a daughter. But you have to be there before them, take them home. Grace wouldn't go home. No, we have to. And the sorrow, pain, post-traumatic stress disorder, they have problems as a couple after that, because Ethan becomes obsessed with the idea that the criminal will not pay when he's asking the police, the authorities, about the what happens next to them. Well, we'll see if we find him, and if you do, the punishment is up to 10 years depending on circumstances. 10 years. So he's not happy with that. He has no closure for a long time. If he finds it, I'm not going to say anything on that. He tries to find on the internet, and then indeed there are groups and there are people who've been through the same thing, and they explain how they don't find the culprit, and then he gets away with too little. He tries to buy a gun after some time. He sees that the police is not advancing with the investigation. In fact, it's not getting anywhere. They don't have any clues, any suspect, anything. And he wants some help. So he goes to this firm, law firm, to see what they can do. And as a strange coincidence, a terrifying twist of fate, seems like. This law firm, the one who is in charge, who's placed in charge with helping Ethan find the one who killed his son, is the man who killed his son, Dwight Arnold. So it's an awkward, of course, exchange, tense. And I will not say what happens, but it is a film with psychological drama.